Just because you cannot see doesn't mean you lack vision. The perfect example of this is 30-year-old Ms. Ashwini Angadi, who is visually impaired from birth. Ms. Ashwini hails from a small village in Bellary. As she was born visually impaired, the acceptance of her disability was not easy for her family. Her parents were told that she will only be a burden to them and they'd rather get rid of her. But her parents' love towards her made them determined to never give up on her. They persisted on raising her nonetheless. Her growing up days were tremendously stressful. Ms. Angadi graduated with a BA from Maharani's College of Arts and Commerce. After graduating, she began joining NGOs, became a spokesperson for disability rights, and joined International Forum to raise awareness on disability discrimination. In 2014, Ms. Angadi established the Ashwini Angadi Trust to empower the disabled along with her father. She also runs the flagship called Bellary Academy, which provides free education to the disabled and underprivileged. Today, she is a global ambassador and advocate of disability rights and also is the recipient of Queen's Young Leader Award. In 2013, she was granted the UN Special Envoy for Global Education Youth Courage Award. In 2016, she was selected to be included in Limca Book of Records. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the voice of the disabled, Miss Ashwini Angadi.
Yeah, hello. Respected the management, teachers, and lovely students. So, good evening to all. How are you all? Yes, how was the session? Yes, thank you very much. And since you are the brighter future of this society, you have to be very always strong to speak, strong to educate and everything. So, let me have a small introduction before I speak. As you already did in the video, but still I just want to take some of the things to share with you. So, I am born and brought up in a small village called Chellagurki. It's in Karnataka, south part of Karnataka. When I born, you know, like I born with a, I mean, I born as a gifted god. I mean, at that time when I born, my parents thought it was a curse. But I always see that I am proud being a visually impaired because I can see with my inner eyes. I will be the better judge compared to you because I see everyone from here, not from here. So, why I am just telling all these things? Because whatever this weakness is, you have to convert it as a strength. Okay? That's what I just wanted to convey you by saying all these things. So, when I grown up, I just want to study like my brothers and sisters do. Then my parents asked the schools in my village to take my admission. Then they refused me because of my disability. Then I had a chance to come to Bangalore and get education in Sri Ramana Maharshi Academy for the Blind. The way the challenges I faced in Ramana Maharshi Academy for the Blind school is twice I was on the deathbed. See, when I was studying in 10th standard, I had a brain fever. Then the doctor told my parents that I won't be alive for a long time. I won't be survive for a long time. Then what happened is, Yeah, and everyone were just depressed, and my parents were depressed. But I took it a challenge that I wrote an exam, 10th standard exam, and I scored a very good 85.5 score. I scored 85.5, and then what happened? And then I would survive. Then doctor said it is a miracle. How could she cured? Then I said, because I made my soul happy, I made my soul satisfied, so the body got recovered. That's what. If we are happy, if we are always positive, definitely no physical harm make you weak. Isn't it? Do you all agree with this? Yes, of course. Then I joined NM Carvey College as my PU, and the challenge I faced here are like mobility issues, because previously what I was doing is I was actually hired school and college in the campus itself. So I had no problem at all, and everyone are, you know, visually impaired, and everyone are, you know, I did not have any issue. But when I came to this college, there is no hostel. So I was the only visually impaired in my college. So I had to catch two buses to my college. Again, I have to go alone to my home. One day or 2 days, 3 days, my mom dropped me and picked me from my college and picked me and dropped me to my college. But how did it happen every day? It takes me almost to 1.5 hour to reach to college from my home. So one day what I told is I told my mom, I actually lied, I did not tell true. I told my mom that my friends will accompany me, so they'll come to drop me to my home, bus stop nearest to my home. Then she agreed, okay. But actually it was not at all a true. I myself explored to go alone, to walk alone, till my college to bus stop, and get down in the bus stop nearest to my home and walk to my home. So, and after a month, I told my mom that I am coming alone, nobody is accompanying me. Then my mom was really astonished. And yeah, this is what in my college days, and I got my education and graduation and degree and everything. So blah, blah, blah. And the secret of my life, I just wanted to share with you. Actually, I wanted to earn so much of money. I want to earn more money because I want to become rich. I want to lead a luxurious life. Because I don't want to remain poor. Because I born in a poor background family, and I know the condition of poverty. Sometimes even not me, but my brothers, my parents, they struggle to get food for 3 times. I did not want that. My dream is, my main dream was to earn so much of money and lead a luxurious life. So for that, I thought, to lead a luxurious life, I want to get a job in corporate sector. To get a corporate job, I want to learn English. I did not know English properly. Then need to be skilled in computers. Then I joined one of the NGOs which taught me computers and with little English. So as my dream became succeed, then I joined as a HR recruiter in one of the companies. Earned almost 35,000 per year, everything, luxurious life, cab used to drop me to my home, pick me from my home, everything was really happy. But once a time, I realized myself, yeah, this is not my life. Because, see, I've taken many things from the society. I should give at least little part of my contribution to the society. Then I realized and quit the job, and I able to join a NGO called Leonard Cheshire Disability. It's an global campaign for young people with disability. I used to lead this project in India, where my responsibilities were going, talking to persons with disabilities, resolving the issues by advocacy and campaign. So I had able to meet so many of persons who are in trouble. Many of them were not able to come out of their homes. These were their lives, and I made them to come out of their homes, and I made them earn on their own. I made them to get education, and now they are in a very good condition of life. They are earning on their own. They are leading their lives independently. So that is why I felt very happy for me. And after that, United Nations organization has awarded me with Youth Courage for Education in the year 2012 on Manala Day at United Nations organization premise in New York. And yeah, thank you. After that, I started my own organization called Ashwini Angadi Trust. And with this, I have a wing institution called Bellary Academy. Now we have 35 students from all around Karnataka who are from poor and economical background families. And the uniqueness of my school is, it is not only for visually impaired or any kind of disabilities. It is an inclusive education where both disabled and non-disabled students, they study together, they play together, they act together, they do everything together, so that the mutual understanding between them will grow up. For we have a special educator for each disability. Only the writing part and reading part comes, they'll separate the classes. Otherwise, in all the subjects, they'll sit together and they study together. So the activities that the students are accomplishing in our institution is yoga, Hindustani classical music, chess, and other types of sports is along with a regular syllabus. So from all these things, what I have learned is, I just want to do something to the society, and I want to just be alive even after the death. But I don't want to be dead even though I am alive. That is the main intention of mine. And I always, it's not a suggestion, because I'm not that big person to suggest you all. But I'll tell you, for every failures, there'll be success. Don't feel depressed for your failures. Accept it as they are, so that success will automatically come. And I always think there is no shortcuts for achieving goals. No, don't find any shortcuts. You have to work hard and work smart. Okay, be an extraordinary person. Do unique things. You know, one of my role models, his name is Dr. David Hartman. He is totally visually impaired, but he had become a doctor. Once he applied for the college for the medical seat, he was rejected because of his disability. And one thing he told is, it is very inspiring. Please, please, please note it down, or please think about it. He says, don't reject me because of my disability. Do you know who is a real disabled? The person who doesn't take any challenges and doesn't do any unique things, he is a real disabled, not me. I can accept the challenge and I am doing very unique, so I am not a disabled. So from these, I would like to tell you all, don't be disabled. Be creative, be unique, be extraordinary. And the type of role model that you take is, you have to be hypnotized When you have to read about them, you have to study about them. Then if I ask you all, who is your role model, who is your hero, you will say Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, you will say Swami Vivekananda, or you will say Sardar Vallabhai Patel, or some, you will say the extraordinary people's name. But if I ask you, what are the hurdles Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam faced? Then you have nothing to say. You just say only he is extraordinary person. No, it should not be like that. But if I ask you, have you seen KGF2? Yes, you will be able to even narrate the whole story of the film. Like that, you have to be with the role models. You have to read about their role models. You have to think about them. I mean, you have to do research on them so that you'll become extraordinary person. So, one thing in my life which has actually inspired me a lot is, my hero is Swami Vivekananda, and he only says, whoever doesn't do anything in your life are the waste of the society. They are waste. They don't know anything. So I don't want to be you all to be waste. Society is looking and expecting something from you. Please do something for the society. And I also have a request from you all. If you want to do anything for the society, I have an option to do. You can do voluntary service in our organization, where you can come and spend time with our students, or if you can even do online service also, that's fantastically acceptable. And you can teach our students English, mathematics, whatever you would wish to do. And you can also try to help us financially to run our school, because mine is a free residential school for poor students, and you can help us in raising funds, and you can also help me in finding those students who are in trouble and drop me to my school. And I also have one more project is coming out, that is, I'm also opening a project called Adults Women with Disability for Employment. And because we were actually, during COVID time, we were supporting women with disabilities with provisions and everything. But I don't want to show them a sympathy. I want to empathize. Means I have to make them earn on their own. They should not extend and for, you know, request. So that is my part. And I always say you all, please do, don't waste your time. Hard work, have a goal, do extraordinary, okay? Okay, thank you very much for your time to listening to me. And it's my honor to be part in this session. Thank you all.
Visionary leaders, who has given the true meaning for the word vision and for proving what vision actually is and giving us all a hindsight of what all of us will have to be looking ourselves to. Her thoughts on we being extraordinary, we needing to be creative enough, and we need to be hardworking have struck the right chord and has given us the food for thought to amply behave and ensure that all of our lives are extraordinary as like theirs are. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Suma, ma'am. Thank you, Ashwini, ma'am.